Hi, this is Vishwanath. I'm a practicing engineer and associated with energy and aviation sector. In my career spanning nearly 36 years, I had the opportunity to work in the entire value chain of conventional and renewable energy sector in various areas, including design, planning, erection, commissioning, and commercial. In the aviation sector, I was involved in planning and the commercial areas. Welcome to the lecture 3 in the module on importance of ethics in engineering profession under the certificate course on life skills for engineers. As we begin the lecture today, let's have a recap of the lecture 2. In the last lecture of Professor Ramabrahmam, we learnt about genesis of ethics and the theories that govern it. In today's lecture, let us explore the areas of ethics in engineering, which we will term as applied ethics. Applied ethics, as you may recall from the last lecture, ethics is divided into meta-ethics, normative ethics, and applied ethics. We have seen in detail about normative ethics. Now let us look at applied ethics. Applied ethics is one of the branches of ethics which deals with analysis of particular moral issue in private and public life. In simple words, applied ethics applies ethical theory to real life situations, specifically in professional areas. Professional ethics is a classic example of applied ethics. Before we learn about professional ethics, let us first understand what a profession is. It is the same as a job of an occupation. We often hear the words, he or she is a professional. What do we mean by this? Let us now look at what is meant by profession so that it becomes easy for us to understand the definition of professional ethics. Keeping the pay aside, let us first have a brief look at the features of a profession as detailed in Engineering Ethics by Charles B. Flederman. First, profession is that requires sophisticated skills, the use of judgment and exercise of discretion, that is to differentiate between right and wrong, and the freedom between right and wrong, and the freedom to act on one's own. Second, the membership in the profession needs extensive formal education. It is not just practical training or apprenticeship. Third, there are special societies or organizations like medical council or engineering councils that are controlled by members of the respective professions. These societies or organizations set the standards or code of ethics, as it is popularly known, as to enforce these standards. And finally, significant public good results from the practice of the profession. Engineering as a profession, now from the attributes what we have just discussed, let us check with respect to engineering, is it a profession? First, engineering, yes, is a profession that requires sophisticated skills, the use of judgment to differentiate between right and wrong, and the freedom to act on one's own. Second, membership in the profession needs formal education like your engineering course. It is not just practical training or experience, but your education too. Yes, there are special societies or organizations like Engineering Council of India and Indian Society for Engineers that are controlled by engineers. They have their standards or code of ethics for admission into the profession and other standards, etc. Finally, significant public good comes out from the practice of the profession of engineering. Let us see the concept of professional ethics. Now that we have known what profession is, let's understand what professional ethics means. Professional ethics is one of the many branches of the area of applied ethics. It is set of standards or principles adopted by professionals. In other words, every profession like engineering, medicine, law, architecture, etc. have their own set of professional ethics. Engineering ethics, for example, deals with identifying the right kind of approach to moral issues in engineering. And what is ethics in engineering? Before we understand why ethics in engineering, let us look at what engineering ethics is. Engineering ethics consists of the responsibilities and rights that ought to be endorsed by those engaged in engineering and also of desirable ideals and personal commitment in engineering. Hence, the ethics in engineering consists of responsibilities or rights that ought to be put in practice. Further, questions arise on who sets these standards and are these standards uniform? Let us have a look. Like we have seen earlier, there are professional societies for engineers at the national and international levels that have come out with the standards or code of ethics. We will look at codes of ethics in detail in the next lecture. To give you some examples of professional societies at the international level, there are bodies like National Society of Professional Engineers, which we call NSPE, American Society of Civil Engineers, the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, and at the national level, there are bodies like Engineering Council of India, Indian Society of Engineers, Indian Society of Mechanical Engineers, and so on. So India is also catching up in having these standards and codes. Now, before we look at ethics in the engineering profession, let us look at some questions. Why should engineers be honest and fair? How well and how efficiently do engineers make the right decisions amidst the multi-dimensional approaches of good and bad in their profession? At this point, it is important that for us to understand significant ethics in engineering. If you recall, in lecture 1, we looked at cases of how set norms were neglected by an engineer in a large multinational cars company. We saw few other cases of flyover collapses, data breaches, and as a result, in some cases, public safety was put at risk, and in some cases, environment was affected, while in some other cases, personal identities of people was at risk. Let us see the trends. You must have come across the recent instances of security issues that are being faced. There are articles on potential threats to Aadhaar data. Similarly, there are cases of Yahoo in which 3 billion users and their accounts came into hacking. Now, there is a fourth industrial revolution that is fast catching up. As we all know, Industrial Revolution 1 was when the steam engine was invented. Industrial Revolution number 2 was when electricity was invented and started using. Number 3 was the communication technology. And the fourth, what we call Revolution 4.0. The fourth industrial revolution is coming together on various technologies like digital, physical, and biological systems. In the wake of breakthrough technologies emerging in various fields like robotics, artificial intelligence, quantum computing, nanotechnology, Internet of Things, etc., there is going to be changes in the way we live our lives, work, and relate. They aim at curing and preventing diseases, improving the quality of life, etc. But these advances in information technology and artificial intelligence have a lot of ethical concerns, including privacy and security. Any unethical decision or practice will have catastrophic impact on businesses and people in the new interconnected world. Let's understand the significance of ethics in engineering. It is very clearly evident that engineering is a profession rather than an occupation, which is characterized by technical competencies, privileges, autonomy, and most importantly, responsibilities. The engineering sector has many aspects, and the social aspect is a critical component. In other words, engineering has an impact on the people, processes, and environment. Be it infrastructure development or mode of communication, engineers are highly regarded for the impact they have on people's lives. At the same time, there are instances like what we have seen earlier, where people's lives are affected in a negative way and large damages take place, which have catastrophic impact on the societies. As engineering professionals, you must keep in mind that high level of technical expertise without adherence to ethical guidelines is as much as a threat to welfare of people as it is to professional incompetency. It is natural that people have high expectations from engineers because of their power, the power to transform people's lives. But you have to always remember the famous quote by Benjamin Parker, "With great power comes great responsibility." So it is important for engineers to decide and act in a responsible and ethical manner. Very clearly, ethics too, like engineering design, has no single solution. For example, a product that has been designed by an engineer may benefit one group or the other. At the same time, it may affect the environment or have a direct impact on the people. So there can be multiple ways at looking at an engineering project. What matters at the end is how ethically sound the engineer has been. Ethics also helps engineers in their professional conduct. Therefore, the role of ethics in engineering is imperative because the integrity of the profession depends on it. The quality of decision making can be characterized by justice being done, equity of the decision taken, and the consequences that would result because of the decision. It is only ethical engineering practices that can make the real true essence of engineering, transforming people's lives. In the lecture tomorrow, we will look in detail about code of ethics and its evolution. These are the references which we have given for the student or the practice engineer to go through. Thank you.